Hi there, SunakiVA once again. I decided to make a video to calm the nerves of everyone that's going through a rough time during this quarantine, so I hope you enjoy.
Hello? Listener? Are you there? I wanted to come by and see if you are all right. You haven't been returning any of my calls. Oh, there you are. You had me worried sick. I thought something terrible had happened to you. It's a good thing that I can be able to see your face once again. May I come in? I brought some things with me that I thought you might like. Oh, thank you. So, how have you been holding up during this whole ordeal? I assume that you've been in contact with your family? Yes, I understand. It's difficult. Being a transfer student and all, and your family's back home in America. Don't worry, I completely understand what you're going through. I haven't been able to see my brother Tensei in a while. Or my mother and father. The school, you see, has been under lockdown. We haven't been able to move or leave the dorms. We can go around campus, of course, but we can't go anywhere else. It's been tough. Midoriya has been trying to calm himself down by taking notes and writing in his journals, which I have encouraged, since it's a good way to distract the mind from everything that's going on right now. Bakugo has not really been talking to anyone. He's been, I can't think of the word. Oh, yes. Thank you, listener. He's been quite annoying during this whole process. I wouldn't necessarily say annoying. It's just he hasn't really responded well to the whole idea of being locked in your dorms on campus. None of us have really taken well to it, although I've been trying to reassure everyone that we will be able to leave and go visit our families soon. It's just that the Prime Minister of Japan hasn't really released a statement on that yet. I've been really worried about everyone. But I've been more worried about you than anything else. It's really hard for me to be able to not see you. It's a miracle that I was actually able to get outside of the campus. Just to visit you and check on you to see how you were. I can only stay here for a short period of time before I'm being called back to the dorms. The Principal Nezu has given us a short period of time to be able to visit our families, although this is the only time that we can. After that, we have to head back to the dorms and obey the rules that the government has been giving us. I hear in America there not taking to it quite lightly. But we must stress that everything that is going on right now is trying to be maintained and under control. And it's given me a moment to think. We aren't really the real heroes here. I know that's a weird thing for me to say, considering the fact that I care so much about being a good hero. But I haven't been able to do as much work as those working in the hospitals and in the stores. And I haven't been able to do anything like they have. They've worked day in and day out, trying their best to be able to grapple with the situation at hand. I can only pray that once all of this is over, that they get the true and undying recognition that they truly deserve. I think that... What was that? Oh, what I had brought you. Oh, yes, sorry. I was going to trail off. I'm almost starting to act like Midoriya. I brought you some books. And I brought you some little card games. I thought that in the short period of time that I'm here with you, we could maybe read or write or play some card games, just to pass the time. I didn't want you to get too bored. I know that you have video game consoles, like a... What is that? A Switch? Nintendo Switch, right? Oh. What is Animal Crossing? Oh, is that that game where you play as a person on an island? Oh, I've heard great things about that. Well, at least great things from Ochako. Ochako and Deku and Shoto actually like that game very much. I'm for one am not really fond of it, but I find that distracting one's self with video games during this difficult period is a good thing to be able to do. Although I take to it that you don't really like playing video games that much. You do? Oh. My mistake for assuming that you didn't. But, back to what I was saying, I also stopped by a convenience store on the way here and I got you a couple snacks. I didn't know if you had any food in your freezer or fridge, so I brought you some ramen noodles, some water, some fruit snacks, some candy. I didn't know exactly what you liked, but I assumed that you would need a lot of junk food to be able to keep yourself occupied. Well, I hope that you like what I got you. I'm not really particularly picky when it comes to getting things for my friends. But I assume that you'll enjoy it? Really? Oh, great. I'm happy. Oh, excuse me. I need to take this. Hello? Oh, Principal Nezu. What seems to be the problem? Yes, I completely understand. No, I'm just visiting a friend. A friend of the family. A very close friend of mine. She lives nearby the school and... Oh. I see. You'll be needing me soon? Oh, yes, of course. I completely understand. Yes, I will be back at the dorms shortly. No, I won't take long. I apologize for any inconvenience. Thank you, Principal Nezu. Yes, I will see you soon. That was Principal Nezu. He said that, I will have to leave shortly. Well, not shortly entirely, it's just... In around 2 hours, I'm due back at the school. So, for the time being, maybe we could enjoy a book or two. Which one would you like me to read? Ah, this one. It's a very interesting book. It's a book about... Oh. I didn't read the title. Crashing Waves. Oh, it must be something about the sea. Would you like me to read it to you? Oh, of course. Allow me, please. Get yourself comfortable, yes. All right. As I gaze upon the world in an unflattering sense, I see an ever-changing atmosphere, surrounded by hope, but shadowed by fear. I take it upon myself, the shield and sword that I have been given since birth, and I arm myself to the teeth, ready to shadow whatever friends that linger around me, and anchor to them the same shield and sword that I have been given, so that we may fight the shadows of death together. The swifting, changing tides of life crash before me as I come to on the shore of a beach that I do not remember nor recall ever visiting. Crashing waves give me a sense of pleasure, a deep, sensible feeling that I am alone in the world. But I look around me and I see the sand. The ever-growing, ever-changing sand. Colors of beige, white, gray, brown, green, blue. I see these colors. They envelop me in a sense of warmth, in a sense of feeling. I am not alone anymore in the world. I have friends. And these, my dear child, are the gifts that I bear to the world. Listener? They're asleep. Sleep well, listener.
Well, it looks like Tenya had some fun visiting you. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe to my channel, and I will see you soon.